So if you're running Google Ads, but you're not experimenting with them, you could be missing out on some serious sales. So today I'm going to share with you how you can run simple A/B tests in Google Ads to boost your results and get more out of your budget. So by the end of this episode, you'll have 5 practical ideas you can try right now to improve your ads to attract more customers. So if you're new here, my name's Josiah Roche, and over the years I've helped generate millions of dollars for my clients by fine-tuning their Google Ads campaigns. And one thing I've learned is that testing isn't just helpful, it's mandatory across every single campaign type you try, even in an industry that you think you're super confident with. Because what we've found is when we've tested the same ads in the same niche, but a different location, they just don't hit the mark the same way and we don't get the same results. And so you've got to test a lot of different things, no matter if you're, you know, we're running different ads for mechanics and we try a mechanics in Brisbane versus mechanics in Ballarat, for example, and the results are totally different, even if the same ads are being used. So we have to then try different things. And this is a video really is a testament to that, I should say. The good news is that setting up A/B tests in Google Ads is actually very, very simple. And I want to explain this before we get into the rest of it. So inside of your account, you might see this section. It's under the campaigns tab and it's called experiments. So if you go into experiments, you click on the big plus button, and you can create a new experiment. So basically, Google asks you to choose one of your existing campaigns that you have right now and to split the traffic in like 50%, 30%, 10% to see which performs better. So basically, and we'll dive into the different ideas very shortly, but basically it's very easy to set up. All you're doing is duplicating your existing campaign and changing a few things and then letting it run for 14 days or 21 days, etc., to see which one outperforms. So let's dive into these 5 A/B test ideas that you can start running today. First one is maximize conversion value versus maximize conversions. This test will help you figure out if you should focus on getting more sales or if you should focus on getting more high ticket sales. So these are very different things to Google. So maximize conversions is just about getting as many sales as possible within your budget. That's it. So as many transactions or as many leads as possible. So this is really good if you all your products or services are very priced the same way. So for example, each lead is worth the same to you or each transaction is worth the same to you, right? Maximize conversions. Whereas maximize conversion value is basically trying to get the most revenue as possible. So this works if you've got, you know, different price points, one lead is worth different than another lead, etc. So that's maximize conversion value. So imagine you run an electronics store and you sell $2,000 TVs and you also sell like $20 headphones, like maybe your JB Hi-Fi or a Harvey Norman type of thing. And so when you're using maximize conversions in this instance, you might sell heaps of different headphones, but you're not making a good profit. And in Google's eyes, they're just thinking, oh, well, you're making lots of sales, you must be doing well. We'll keep finding more people who are going to buy these headphones. But on the business end and the back end, you're probably thinking, wow, I'm not making as much money as I thought it would be making. So in this instance, if you want to sell more of those high ticket $2,000 TVs, you might want to switch to a maximized conversion value bidding strategy, where Google will try to help you sell more of them and increase your total revenue, not the total number of sales. So they're two different things. So as you can imagine, like this will help you a lot to determine whether or not a performance max campaign or a different search campaign is bringing in enough high value transactions. Or if you've got leads, for example, you might find that roughly each lead spends the same way and you just want to increase the amount of leads, total leads or total phone calls you're getting, right? And you might want to just use maximize conversions, but it's good to test both of these. And you might be thinking, you know, if you're a local business, that you can't track the maximize conversion value, where there are actually tools out there like WhatConverts where you can feed the algorithm how much a lead was worth to you. So all leads are different. There might be a lead might be worth $1,200 in lifetime value to you, or a lead might spend $100 and never come back, right? And you can actually feed the algorithm this info so it can find better people for you. Okay, so that's test number one. It's testing maximize conversion value versus maximize conversions. Good experiment to run. Next experiment to run is broad match versus phrase match versus exact match. This is for search campaigns. Broad match casts a huge wide net and Google will show your ad for searches that are loosely related to your keyword. And I'll explain this in a sec, but it's not the exact term. So for example, if you own a plumbing business, if you're targeting keywords as a broad match for like plumber or plumber nearby, etc., your ad might show up for searches like plumber salary or how to become a plumber, and also plumber nearby. You know, it's all these kind of searches that you don't want to enter into. And it's going to like cast that wide net that's probably not within your budget, you know, to get into. And so you'll get more visibility, yes, with broad match, but not necessarily the right audience that turn into actual leads. Whereas if you switch to phrase match or exact match, you can use keywords like emergency plumber near me, and Google will try to just target people exactly typing those kind of keywords in. So you're actually finding people who want your services. So why do you test this? Why do you test broad match versus exact match? So the idea is that sometimes you're not getting as much sales as you want when you're running phrase and exact, and you need to really broaden your horizon and try to find more people. So the idea is you'd run an experiment and set every keyword that you're bidding on as exact and phrase, and then creating another experiment and setting them all as broad and compete them against each other, pit them against each other to see, well, which is actually getting you more leads. You might find the broad match gets you more leads, but some of those leads aren't as good quality as what you had with the exact and phrase match type. So that's a good idea to run. What we found is for some clients, even if they're in the same niche, sometimes the broad match works better. You know, it just does. It's weird. So it's good to like pit them against each other and see what will work for you. The third type of test is testing different landing pages. Now, this is a very easy one. It's common sense. You might already think to do this. But a lot of people actually don't run the experiments in Google Ads. So in the experiment tab, make sure you duplicate your campaign and try to change the target URL or final URL for different landing pages that you have. So even the small tweaks to your landing page can really impact whether or not someone converts. That could be something as simple as changing the first headline people see at the top of the page, which then gets them to keep scrolling down. But basically, let's say that you're promoting family law services. You're a law firm. And you've got one landing page that really highlights your experience, shows your team, has a very clear call to action for a booked free consultation and offer. And let's say it's very short, like it's a landing page with two sections on it. And then you have another landing page, which is much, much longer. And it's got like social proof, testimonials, case studies. It's got your success rate. It breaks down your process and why they should choose you. And, you know, you're relating to them. So it's good to test these kind of big stark differences so that you can go in the right direction. And you can easily do this with Google Ads, basically splitting your campaign into two, splitting the traffic in half, 50% each, and then sending the traffic to different landing pages so that you can start to test the conversion rate. Very, very important experiment for that one. The fourth one is manual CPC bidding versus maximized clicks, okay? So this is basically, should you control the cost yourself or let Google's algorithm take over? That's basically what you're trying to do right here. So manual CPC bidding gives you more control over the cost per click for each keyword that you have. So you set the maximum cost per click that you're willing to spend for each keyword, whereas maximized clicks is basically hands off. You're basically telling Google how much you're willing to spend on any given keyword. You could set it to like maximize clicks with a limit of $2, and you're not willing to spend any more than $2 across all keywords. Or you can just, you know, not set any limits and basically say maximize clicks in general. And you just, so you've got $10 a day, and you tell Google, go nuts, just get me as many clicks as you can with this $10. So why would you test these two together? So if you're a lawyer or a plumber, you probably know which keywords bring in the best results. So with manual CPC, you can focus on high intent words like family lawyer near me or emergency plumber near me, etc., and bid more aggressively on those ones. But if you're running a campaign with hundreds of keywords and you don't want to manage every single one and every kind of permutation of keyword out there, then maximized clicks is a lot more easy to manage, and you can aim to drive as much traffic as possible within your budget. Now, there's a big caveat here, because if you are a lawyer or a plumber, you might find that there are like three or four or five different keywords that kind of get you a lot of leads, and you might want to bid more on those. And you might find that a lot of different other keywords never get you leads, and for some reason you've spent hundreds and hundreds of dollars on these ones over time. Basically, you're willing to enter into those options for those keywords, but not for the highest ticket price. For example, you're not willing to bid on those keywords if they're $50 a click, but you are if they're $20 a click. So you might set those ones as $20 a click max, and you're willing to enter into auctions at $20. But as soon as it exceeds that, you want to exit that auction, not bid on that, right? So that's kind of manual CPCs there. Whereas Maximise Clicks makes way more sense for other businesses where the cost per click isn't as high and you don't need that much control over it, right? So that's a good test to run, especially if you are a lawyer or a plumber and you want to test your hypothesis on whether or not you should go manual CPC versus Maximise Clicks for a certain campaign that you're running. So the fifth and final test is testing different ad creatives and audience signals within a Performance Max campaign. So Performance Max is very, very popular at the moment. It's getting better and better and better, especially for e-commerce stores. And actually, it works pretty well for local-based businesses trying to generate more bookings. And so what you might do is you might find that you've been running a Performance Max for like 2 to 3 months, right? And you might find that, you know, there's certain audience signals that seem to be working, but you haven't really ventured out to more than one Performance Max or more than 2 or 3. And so the idea is that you want to basically duplicate your existing Performance Max exactly how it is, that it's been performing well. And you want to swap out either the audience signals that you've got in each asset group, or you might want to test the different creative that you're running, different headlines, different descriptions, etc. The idea is that you want to test one thing at a time, though, so you're not super confused. So, for example, you might want to test, basically duplicate your existing campaign within the experiments feature and split 50% of the traffic and basically go through all your ads and change up the headlines. Or you might want to change up the URLs, the target URLs, or you might want to change up the imagery you use. Just test one thing at a time, right? And then move on to audience signals. You might want to test different audience signals and see if they beat your current Performance Max campaign. This is a very, very good test idea because you can see which moves the needle more for you. And so by mixing and matching, you know, different creatives, eventually you get to mix and match. You can find out which combinations drive the most engagement and conversions. And yeah, it just helps you just refine it over time and stretch your budget more and getting more profitability. So there you have it. There's 5 very simple and easy A/B test ideas that you can run to improve your Google Ads. So number 1 was maximize conversion value versus maximize conversions, right? So it helps you determine whether or not you need to focus on getting more sales or increase your average order value and getting more profit or more revenue coming through. The second experiment idea was broad match versus phrase match and exact match. So finding out if targeting broader searches or specific searches works better for your profitability. Number 3 was testing different landing pages. So seeing which landing page content and design converts more visitors into actual customers. Number 4 was manual CPC bidding versus maximized clicks. So figuring out whether or not you need to manually control each click and how much you bid on them, or let the algorithm do its thing. Number 5 was testing different ad creatives and audience signals within a Performance Max to see which one resonates most and obviously gets you more customers at a lower CPA or cost per acquisition. So as a marketer, I've learned that testing is pretty much everything. I've worked with a lot of different marketers and we find that, you know, we might have our own suspicions on what might work and we might take a guess and then be totally wrong, you know, and that's why we've got testing. That's why experiments even exist, so that you can test your hypothesis, see what works. So make sure with each of these experiments, you run them for at least a couple of weeks each, right? So if you go low budget, make sure you run it for a longer period of time so you can collect enough data. You'll know what's enough based on your average cost per click. So for example, if you're a injury lawyer, right, and your cost per click is $50 to $100 each click, then and you only had $100 a day as your budget, then you might get 30 clicks by the end of the month. So you might find that whether or not that 30 clicks is enough, or you need to wait 2 or 3 months before you can like run a proper test, right? But it's obviously less dramatic for retail and other businesses with dramatically less CPCs. So biggest thing, keep experimenting, keep tweaking, and you'll keep improving. That's the main thing. Google Ads is an investment. It's not a one-off thing. You're training the algorithm so that it works towards your business's advantage, right? Thanks for hanging out with me today. I hope these tips inspired you to create your own different experiments. And until next time, keep testing, and I'll catch you in the next episode. Cheers.